Hello, and welcome to the Granite Desk. I'm Ranger Sarah Jane.
And I'm Ranger Simone, and we're coming to you from Joshua Tree National Park. One reason why this park is special is its unique landscape. One of the most common questions people ask is why the rocks look the way they do. Today, we are going to adventure to some unusual rocks and learn why they are shaped the way they are.
Before we leave to go exploring, let's think about the rocks where you live. Do you see rocks when you go outside? What are they like? Around here, the rocks are very rough. They feel like sandpaper. They're not smooth like rocks I might expect to find near a river or a lake.
Let's meet Ranger Kylie. She can explain how these rocks got here and why they look like this.
This feature next to me is called Arch Rock, and I bet you can guess why. This rock sees thousands of visitors each year, all coming to check out its unique shape. It looks this way because of the way the rocks formed a long, long time ago.
Millions of years ago, intense heat and pressure melted rock in the Earth's crust, forming magma. The magma rose upward through the crust, though it never quite reached the surface. The molten rock cooled very, very slowly, allowing large crystals to grow over time. These big crystals are why we have such a rough texture of rock here, and you can see the different colors, which are different minerals in the rock. After these rocks cooled and hardened underground, they were under a lot of pressure.
They formed parallel cracks, giving Arch Rock its long and narrow shape. Water flowed along those cracks, rounding out the corners, and eventually the surrounding soil was eroded away, exposing this beautiful feature that we see today. Most of these rocks here in Joshua Tree share the same geologic past, resulting in an endless variety of shapes. Today, wind and water are still at work carving out the arch, just like they're acting on all of Joshua Tree's rock formations. The desert can be a pretty extreme place. Big storms, harsh temperatures, and even plants and animals continue to break down these rocks into smaller and smaller pieces. So next time you're hiking in the desert and you get sand in your shoes, remember those tiny little sand grains were once part of a big boulder.
This has been Ranger Kylie for the Granite Desk. Back to you.
Wow, thanks Ranger Kylie. I learned so much about Joshua Tree's rocks. I love how they make so many cool shapes. What do you call a scientist that studies rocks?
If I break the word down, geo means earth and ology means study of something. Ranger Kylie studies the earth and its rock formations, so she is a geologist.
There are lots of other types of scientists that study things that are related to the earth. Like a paleontologist studies fossils that are found in the ground, an ecologist studies how living things interact. If you are a scientist, what would you want to study?
Thanks again for joining us on another Granite Desk adventure.
What will we explore next?